इफ या काश काश काश, अगर सब काश से हो जाए तो दुनिया में कभी किसी को किसी चीज की कमी ना हो, पर ऐसा नहीं होता. थिंग्स डोंट वर्क दिस वे. दैट इज व्हाई द स्कॉटिश प्रोवर्ब इफ विशेस वर हॉर्सेस बेगर्स वुड राइड. इट मीन्स दैट इफ एवरीथिंग कुड हैपन जस्ट बाय विशिंग, देन इन दिस वर्ल्ड इवन द मोस्ट डेस्टिट्यूट पीपल और इवन द बेगर्स, they would have everything they wished for. But things don't happen like this. So let's see in this play what happens with If I Were You. So these are the characters. The first character, Gerard, he's alert, smart, intelligent. He's of medium height. He wears horn-rimmed glasses, dressed in a lounge suit and a great coat, and he has a cultured voice. So these are the main characteristics of our protagonist. Then we have Intruder. He's scheming, he's self-assured, cocky, criminal, oversmart, he has cruel intentions, and he thinks that he can befool everyone. Let's see whether he is able to or not. Now this is scene 1. When the curtain rises, Gerard is standing by the table. He is on the phone talking to someone. So our protagonist kisi se phone pe baat kar raha hai when the curtain rises. So what he says, well, tell him to phone up directly. I must know. Yes, I expect. I'll still be here, but you must not count on that. In about 10 minutes time, right, oh goodbye. So he is telling that other person ki wo abhi wahi pe hai. So he is expecting the other person to call back in about 10 minutes. So he says goodbye, and after that he starts packing his bag in a traveling, his things in a traveling bag, when another man who is similar in build to Gerard, he enters silently. So that man is having a revolver in his hand. So from here, the suspense is building in the play. He accidentally bumps into the table, and listening to the noise, Gerard turns. Very coolly, he says, this is a surprise. Intruder, I don't think you'll be pleased for long. Put those paws up. So the intruder with a revolver in his hand, उसे कहता है कि अपने हाथ ऊपर करो. So Gerard finds it very melodramatic, but tries to keep his cool, which ruffles the intruder. So Gerard, उसको ये एक ड्रामा एक मूवी की तरह लगता है, एंड ही डज व्हाट ही सेज, बट ही कीप्स हिज कूल. ही इज नॉट एट ऑल नर्वस. ही देयर इज नो साइन ऑफ एनी स्केरीनेस ऑन हिज फेस, एंड दिस रफल्स द इंट्रूडर. यू विल सून स्टॉप बीइंग स्मार्ट. आई विल मेक यू क्रॉल. आई वांट टू नो अ फ्यू थिंग्स. सी, सो द इंट्रूडर सेज दैट डोंट ट्राई टू बी स्मार्ट. आई विल मेक यू क्रॉल. यू Can't you see this revolver in my hand? So he says, I want to know a few things. So Gerard says that he is ready to answer all the questions, but first he wants to sit in a comfortable position. So he says, at last, a sympathetic audience. So Gerard, he says, at last, koi to mujhe sunne wala aaya. So now this is an ironic remark, because Gerard, he pretends to be very excited to have someone to talk to, whereas the intruder is there not to share or listen to his story. He is there to extract some information for his plan. So Gerard जो है वो pretend करता है, वो दिखा रहा है कि वो उसे बहुत खुशी है कि कोई उसे उसकी बातें share करने के लिए आया. But actually the intruder is not there to share, but he is there to extract some information for his plan. So he actually wants the intruder to believe Gerard. He wants the intruder to believe that he is not at all feeling threatened by his presence. So अपने आप को cool दिखाने के लिए, so Gerard, he is talking like this to intruder to show that he is not at all afraid of him. So Gerard then starts narrating his story. So he sits very comfortably. Look at the attitude in the picture he is showing, and he sits very comfortably and starts narrating his life story. But the intruder obviously doesn't want to listen to his life story, and he says he just wants his answers. So the first question, do you live here alone, Gerard? If I don't answer that, so intruder then warns him that he may choose not to answer if he wants to get hurt. So at this, Gerard, he says that I think good sense is shown more in the ability to avoid pain than in the mere desire to do so. Why do you think, Mr.? So he doesn't know the name of the intruder. So he says, he stops after Mr. He wants the intruder to speak his name. So Gerard says that I think good sense. So here it means that intelligence prevails in the ability to avoid pain. So Gerard says that an intelligent person would rather try to avoid pain rather than showing the desire to inflict pain. So he is actually trying to say that he is smarter than intruder, because intruder is trying to give pain to him. He is trying to hurt him, whereas Gerard, he wants no such thing. So this is a sarcasm, a sarcastic remark. The intruder doesn't want to tell his name, so rather he poses his next question. So he says, "Never mind my name. I like yours better, Mr. Gerard. What is your Christian name?" So he wants to know his full name. Now, Christian names. What are Christian names? Christian names, or these are also the baptismal names. So these are the personal name. Formally, it is given to Christians at christening. So Christian name, it is often loosely used to mean any person's first name as distinct from his or her surname. So mostly the first name, they are the Christian names. So he says Vincent Charles. So that is his Christian name. Then intruder, "Do you run a car?" So this is the third question that intruder asked. "Do you run a car?" So Gerard says, "No." Intruder, "That's a lie. You're not dealing with a fool. I'm as smart as you and smarter, and I know you run a car. Better be careful, wise guy." So now again, the intruder, he already knows that he has a car. So therefore, intruder says that, "Don't try to be smart. I know that you have a car. So wise guy, don't play this with me." So intruder, he warns Gerard that the revolver is in his hand and that revolver is not a toy. And he could hurt him without killing him. And even then, he would have to answer him. So he says that he may not kill him with the revolver because he still wants his answers, but of course he can hurt him. So he says even if he hurts him, then he will have to answer again. So it's better that he answers the questions without getting hurt. So Gerard therefore humbly admits that yes, he has a car. So as if to let the intruder enjoy his win for a while. So Gerard at that time, so he is keeping his cool. He's not showing any nervousness and he admits that he has a car. So there's a revolver in the hand of the intruder. So therefore, Gerard, he's trying to keep his presence of mind and his cool. Now the fourth question. Intruder, he says, "That's better. So two people often come out here." So now he's trying to know whether or how many people visit Gerard. So Gerard tells him that he's not visited by many people, only a baker comes, then a greengrocer, and a milkman. So then he comes to his next question. Rather, it's not a question, but it is more of a confirmation. So he says, "I happen to know that you never see tradespeople." So he says that not many business people, he is not meeting many business people. So Gerard, he's quite surprised to see that intruder knows a lot about him. So therefore, he asks him to tell something about him. So Gerard, उसको लगता है कि इंट्रूडर को उसके बारे में काफ़ी जानकारी है. वो कहता है कि अब कुछ अपने बारे में भी बताओ. सो नाउ इंट्रूडर, ही सेज, "आई कुड टेल यू प्लेंटी. यू थिंक यू आर स्मार्ट, बट आई एम टॉप ऑफ द क्लास राउंड हियर. आई हैव गॉट ब्रेन्स एंड आई यूज देम एंड दैट्स ऑल आई हैव गॉट वेयर आई हैव." सो नाउ दीज लाइन्स टेल अस दैट हाउ बोस्टफुल द इंट्रूडर इज एंड ही फील्स दैट ही इज अबव एवरी वन. सो ही सेज, "आई एम टॉप ऑफ द क्लास राउंड हेयर एंड आई हैव गॉट ब्रेन्स एंड आई यूज देम एंड दैट इज वाई आई हैव रीच्ड दैट इज हाउ आई हैव रीच्ड वेयर आई एम." नाउ एट दिस Gerard mocks at his overconfidence and he says, "And where precisely have you gone? It didn't require a great brain to break into my little cottage." So Gerard, he mocks at him and he says, "Meri ye cottage mein andar aane ke liye koi zyada brain ki zarurat to nahi thi." So he's mocking at him that it didn't require a great brain to break into my little cottage. So now the intruder slyly tells him that when you would know the exact reason, you'll be surprised and it won't be a pleasant one. So now the intruder, he wants to answer him back because he feels that Gerard is trying to be smart. So he says, "Ki agar asli baat pata lag gayi, so then you'll be surprised, or wo koi pleasant surprise nahi hone wala." So Gerard says that, "It is quite clear from your behavior and the way you have entered my cottage that your purpose is not going to be a pleasant one." So Gerard says, "Ki jis tarah tum andar aaye ho and the way you are holding your revolver in your hand, so mujhe pehle hi pata hai ki tumhara jo purpose hai, that's not going to be a pleasant one." So Gerard asks him about his line of crime or if he is a specialist. सो जो डार उसे पूछता है कि असल में वो क्या काम करता है, या फिर कोई वो कोई भी क्राइम या कोई भी काम कर लेता है, कोई स्पेशल थिंग नहीं है. सो इंट्रूडर ही टेल्स दैट हिज स्पेशलिटी इज ज्यूल रॉबरी एंड योर कार विल डू मी अ ट्रीट, इट्स सर्टेनली अ डैंडी बस. वो बताता है कि वो ज्यूल रॉबर है और उसे उसकी कार, जेरार्ड की कार जो है उसमें बहुत हेल्प करेगी. बट जेरार्ड देन टेल्स हिम दैट ही इज एट अ रॉन्ग प्लेस बिकॉज ज्यूल्स आर हार्डली फाउंड इन एसेक्स. इंट्रूडर हियर एस्टॉनिशेस जेरार्ड विद हिज रिप्लाई. सो जब जेरार्ड उसको बताता है कि यहाँ एसेक्स में ज्यादा लोगों के पास ज्यूल्स नहीं है, सो उसका काम यहाँ नहीं बनेगा. बट द नेक्स्ट आंसर दैट इंट्रूडर गिव्स दैट एस्टॉनिशेस जेरार्ड. सो अगेन अ सस्पेंस इज क्रिएटेड हियर. सो देयर इज थ्रिल एंड देयर सस्पेंस. सो इंट्रूडर सेज, सो आर द कॉप्स, आई कैन रिटायर हियर नाइसली फॉर अ लिटिल व्हाइल. सो जेरार्ड ही इज लिटिल स्टार्टल्ड हियर एंड ही सेज दैट दिस इज अ सडन डिसीजन. And he says that he's not invited him. So there, as Gerard, he remarks and he talks to the intruder. So his sarcastic remarks, they're amusing for the reader. So wo play ko thoda light bana dete, otherwise it would have been a very serious play. So Gerard kehta hai ki ye to ek achanak se liya hua ye decision hai, aur he says that maine to kisi ko invite nahi kiya. So intruder, he is planning to retire there to chill out for a while in his cottage. Now intruder is slowly and slowly revealing his plan. So he tells Gerard that he would not be there for long, so there was no reason to take permission. So woh Gerard ko batata hai ki Gerard wahan pe zyada der hone hi nahi wala, to use permission lene ki kya zarurat thi. So Gerard doesn't understand anything. So intruder now further explains that this is your big surprise, I am going to kill you. So Gerard at this says, this is a little too much. It's a little harsh thing, isn't it? So intruder with a heavy sarcasm. So he says, yeah, I'll be sorry to do that. I've taken a fancy to you, but it's just got to be done. So he says, ki mujhe tum kuch acche lagne lage ho, par ye to mujhe karna hi hai. So he says, it's got to be done. So to Gerard's question to why to add a murder to your other crimes, the intruder answers that he was not doing it for fun. He had been hunted by police for a long time. He further adds that he is already wanted for murder and they can't hang him twice. So wo usko asli baat batata hai that police is after him. He's a wanted criminal. He has already murdered someone. And now they cannot hang him twice. Even if he murders another person, he will be hanged only once. So still, Gerard is not clear about the intruder's aim. So he says, you are planning a gratuitous double. So gratuitous, it means done without any good reason. So to speak, admitted, you have nothing to lose. But what have you to gain? So Gerard, he is asking him, okay, you don't have anything to lose. मुझे मार के तुम्हारे पास किसी चीज का खोने का कोई खतरा नहीं है, पर तुम्हें मिलेगा क्या? सो ही सेज व्हाट विल यू गेन, बिकॉज जेरार्ड ही इज नॉट एट ऑल रिलेटेड टू इंट्रूडर, ही हैज डन नथिंग टू हार्म द इंट्रूडर. सो जेरार्ड इज नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाई ही हैज चोजन हिम. सो नाउ द इंट्रूडर रिवील्स हिज रियल पर्पस. सो ही सेज दैट आई विल गेन फ्रीडम आफ्टर किलिंग यू. As for myself, I am a poor hunted rat. As Windsor Charles Gerard, I am free to go places and do nothing. I can eat well and sleep and without having to be ready to beat it at the sight of a cop. So he says that I'll take your identity. And as Windsor Charles Gerard, I'll be free to go anywhere. I'll be free to do anything. I can eat well. I can sleep well. And I won't be then running on seeing a cop anywhere. So ready to beat it at the sight of cop means to run away at the sight of a cop. Now Gerard then says that most melodramas, the villain is foolish enough to delay his killing and get frustrated or caught. You're much luckier. So now Gerard is telling him that what happens in most movies, in most melodramatic plays, villain, he is foolish, और विलन जो है वो एंड तक बातें करता रहता है, वेट करता रहता है एंड डजंट किल द पर्सन ही वांट्स टू किल. और एंड में क्या होता है कि पुलिस आ जाती है और उसे पकड़ लेती है. सो ही सेज दैट यू आर मच लकियर. नाउ व्हाट ही मींस बाय दिस that we'll read. So now by you're much luckier, he means that this delay is going to prove good for you, not like the villains of the most melodramatic plays. So Gerard ka kehne ka matlab hai ki ye delay jo abhi tak tumne nahi mara mujhe, so isme kuch acha hoga tumhare liye. So not like the other villains that police comes and the police takes hold of the villain. So now on page 142, the intruder doesn't pay much attention to what Gerard has said and says that he just has to be Winsor Charles Gerard. He imitates the way Gerard speaks and asks Gerard to look at him carefully and see if something is missing. So wo Gerard ko uski tarah bol ke dikhata hai, copy karke dikhata hai jaise wo phone pe baat kar raha tha, and then he says that look at me, do you find anything missing? So now Gerard, he points out that his dressing sense was not like at him at all, was not like his. So he says that it would rather put him in danger. So if he dresses like that, it would be a danger for him. So intruder says that his clothes are going to fit him very nicely. So now Gerard says that everything is okay, but you didn't understand when I said that you were much luckier. He says that he was not praising him for his intelligence, but there has to be a genuinely good reason to kill him. So Gerard, he's still stuck at his point that there still has to be a genuinely good reason to kill him. So Gerard further adds that you let him go and thank God for not shooting me earlier. So he now tells the intruder ki agar intruder usse jaane deta hai, toh baad mein intruder jo hai, भगवान का बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करेगा कि मैंने जेराड को नहीं मारा. सो नाउ इंट्रूडर ही एक्सप्रेसेस हिज फ्रस्ट्रेशन एंड आस्क्स दैट व्हाट वाज ऑन हिज माइंड. सो इंट्रूडर इज नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट जेराड इज टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो ही सेज कि क्या आखिर कहना क्या चाहते हो. सो नाउ जेराड देन सेज दैट यू वॉन्ट टू टेक माई आइडेंटिटी बाई किलिंग मी एंड एल्यूड पुलिस, बट दिस प्लान इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क. सो जेराड उसे कहता है कि ये प्लान जो है तुम्हारा, ये काम नहीं करने वाला. So intruder says that he has done all the planning for this. Here he tells why he's on the run. So intruder usse kehta hai ki wo sari taiyari karke aaya hai, aur fir wo use asli baat batata hai. Now what he tells that now listen here, I have got this all planned. I did a job in town, things went wrong, and I killed the cop. Since then I have done nothing but dodge. So he says that I did a job in town, maybe a jewel robbery, and वहाँ पे पुलिस आ जाती है, and he says that he killed a cop. तो उस दिन से वो कह रहा है कि he has done nothing but dodge. Nothing but dodge means कि वो पुलिस से ही बचता घूम रहा है उस दिन से. So he says like this, running from police one day, he reached Aylesbury, and there he saw Gerard. So there he saw Gerard in his car. So two other people saw you and started to talk. So वहाँ पे दो लोग जेराड को देख के उसके बारे में कुछ बातें करने लगते हैं, and intruder उनकी बातें सुन लेता है. So it looks like you are a bit queer, kind of a mystery man. So उनकी बातें सुन के this intruder feels कि ये जेराड जो है एक kind of एक mystery man है. So now जेराड he wants to explain the mystery, but the intruder continues. So जेराड उसको वो मिस्ट्री समझाने लगता है, पर इंट्रूडर उसकी बात नहीं सुनता और अपनी बात कहता है. सो इंट्रूडर सेज डिसरिगार्डिंग हिम दैट यू फोन योर ऑर्डर्स एंड समटाइम्स यू गो अवे सडनली एंड देन कम बैक जस्ट द सेम. दोज आर जस्ट थिंग्स आई वांट टू डू. हियरिंग अबाउट यू वाज वन ऑफ माय लकीस्ट ब्रेक्स. सो इंट्रूडर उसे कह रहे हैं कि तुम बहुत अजीब अजीब हरकतें करते हो, लाइक यू ऑर्डर थिंग्स ऑन द फोन एंड समटाइम्स यू जस्ट गो सडनली एंड देन अगेन सडनली यू कम बैक. सो ही सेज ये सारी बातें मुझे सूट करती हैं, एंड फाइंडिंग यू वॉज माई लकीस्ट ब्रेक. सो ही सेज दैट ही फील्स लकी दैट ही हैज फाउंड हिम. सो ही सेज दैट ही हैज किल्ड अ कॉप एंड दैट इज वाई नाउ ही इज ऑन द रन. नाउ जेराड सेज दैट यू लाइक्ड मी बींग अ काइंड ऑफ मिस्टीरियस मैन, but you didn't have this intelligence to check why I am surrounded by in mystery. So Gerard usse kehte hain ki okay, tumhe ye pata lag gaya that mystery surrounds me, lekin tumne ye koshish nahi ki pata karne ki that why I am a mysterious man. So now the intruder, he prepares his gun to shoot Gerard as he says that this conversation bored him. So intruder, he says that he is not at all interested in all this, but Gerard warns him and he announces that don't be a fool. If you shoot, you will hang for sure. If not as yourself, then as Vincent Charles Gerard. So he speaks this, and this comes as a big surprise for the intruder. So Gerard उसे कहता है कि अगर उसने उसे मार दिया तो फिर तो उसे फांसी पक्की है, अगर इंट्रूडर की वजह से नहीं तो फिर एज विंसेंट चार्ल्स जेरार्ड. तो दिस वॉज अ शॉक फॉर द इंट्रूडर. सो जेरार्ड सेज दैट दिस इज योर बिग सरप्राइज नाउ. आई सेड यू वोंट किल मी एंड आई वॉज राइट. व्हाट डू यू थिंक आई एम हेयर टुडे एंड गॉन टुमारो. नेवर सी ट्रेड्स पीपल. यू से माई हैबिट्स वुड सूट यू. यू आर अ क्रूक. डू यू थिंक दैट आई एम अ संडे स्कूल टीचर. सो नाउ जेरार्ड एक्सप्लेन्स कि तुमने खुद ही कहा that I am here one day and then I am gone tomorrow. मैं किसी से ज़्यादा बात नहीं करता. So my habits जो है वो बिल्कुल तुम्हें suit करेंगी. तो अगर तुम एक चोर हो, if you are a robber, तो तुम्हें क्या लगता है कि मैं क्या हूँ, एक Sunday school teacher हूँ. So Sunday school teacher is a reference to father in a church. So games up as far as I'm concerned. So वो कहता है कि मेरे तो गेम ख़त्म है. Things went wrong with me. I said it with bullets and got away. So वो कहता है कि मेरे साथ भी कुछ गड़बड़ हो गई और मेरे को भी फायरिंग करनी पड़ी. So I said it with bullets. So he says that even he has killed someone. And unfortunately they got one of my men. So there here is the police. So he says unfortunately मेरा एक आदमी पकड़ा गया and found things the fool should have burnt. और पुलिस को वो चीज़ें मिल गई जो कि उसे जला देनी चाहिए थी. So tonight he says I'm expecting trouble. My bag's packed, ready to clear off. There it is. So वो जो bag pack कर रहा था वो bag उसे दिखाता है and says that look, here is my bag. I was packing my bag. I was about to leave when you entered. So the intruder, he looks at all the things and say, oh, it's the bag, all right. And this is the gun also, all right. But what is all this? So Gerard, he says that this is the disguise outfit. These are the false mustaches and maybe the hat and all. So now do you believe me? So intruder is not sure. So still intruder is now thinking. So Gerard says that for God's sake, clear your muddled head and let's go. So they say that pagalpan chodo and chalo mere saath. So come with me in the car and I can use you. If you find it's a frame, you've got me in the car and you still have got your gun. So Gerard usse kehta hai कि अगर उसे लगता है कि मैं झूठ बोल रहा हूँ तो कार में मैं उसके साथ ही हूँगा और उसके हाथ में रिवॉल्वर भी है तो देन ही वुड किल मी. सो नाउ द इंट्रूडर इज ट्रैप्ड बट ही स्टिल वांट्स जेरार्ड दैट ही वुड बी वॉचिंग हिम. सो जेरार्ड क्लेरिफाइज दैट हिज इनफॉर्मर इज स्टैंडिंग ऑन द मेन रोड कीपिंग एन आई ऑन द पुलिस एंड ही वुड रिंग अप इफ ही सीज एनी ट्रबल. सो जेरार्ड उसे कहता है कि उसका एक इन्फॉर्मर है जो कि मेन रोड पर खड़ा है एंड if he sees police approaching his cottage he would call him. So this phone, this call him, when the phone rings it is the same phone that Gerard, he said he would be waiting within 10 minutes. So at that moment the phone rings. So if you remember the phone call Gerard talks about in the beginning, so Gerard then asks the intruder to hurry up and leave through the secret door that opens into the garage. So as the phone rings, Gerard, he tells the intruder that this is his informer calling. So he asks the intruder to hurry up and to leave through a secret door that opens into the garage. So the intruder, how do I know that you're telling the truth? So Gerard says, oh, don't be a fool. Look for yourself. So Gerard, he tells the intruder to look for her himself and he opens the door and steps away. So intruder, he leans forward to inspect it and with a sight towards the Gerard but with a revolver ready. So as he turns his head, Gerard gives him a push into the cupboard, knocking the revolver out of his hand. He slams the door and locks it, picks up the revolver, goes to the phone where he stands with his gun pointed at the cupboard door. So now the phone was still ringing, so he locks the cupboard and then he goes and picks the phone and he says, hello, yes, speaking, sorry, I can't let you have the props in time for rehearsal. I've had a spot of bother. Quite amusing. So he calls this whole incident a spot of bother and a very amusing one. He says, I think I'll put it up in my next place. So now from here we come to know that he is maybe an actor, director and a playwright. So he says that I'll be using this plot in my next play. Listen, Can you tell our friend the sergeant to come up here at once? You'll probably find him in the public bar. So he tells the other person to call police so that they can catch hold of a wanted murderer. So this is the play, and quite interesting one, quite amusing. The character Gerard, he outwits the intruder, and intruder who thinks that he can befool everyone is actually caught in the end. So now let's do the theme. So if the play If I Were You by Douglas James, it is a thrilling play rich in suspense and irony. So you'll find both suspense and irony in the play. It revolves around the fact that an alert person with calm mind can make anything possible. So this line you can use when you are answering long questions. So it revolves around the fact that an alert person with a calm mind can make anything possible, as Gerard did. So Gerard is a simple man of medium height and build. Nothing robust or muscular about him to deal with a criminal. So he was not a muscular man nor an athlete who could fight a criminal. But it was his intelligence, it was his presence of mind because of which he was able to save himself. So under the given circumstances, anyone like him could have given in to a wanted criminal like the intruder. But it is Gerard's presence of mind and tact that enables him to outwit even a hardened murderer and get him arrested. So this is the theme. With presence of mind, with tact, you can outwit anyone. So the play celebrates the theme of not losing one's cool and acting wisely even when in a tight corner. So even when you are in a fix, you are in a problem, so you should not get nervous, you should not get agitated, you should not lose your cool. Only then you'll be able to come out of that problem. So this is the message also from the play. So this is the theme. Now we come to humor. So this is a very important question for this play, humor. So what kind of humor the author has used and how this humor helps to build the character of Gerard and makes the play interesting. So the play deals with a thrilling plot of wishful thinking of a criminal who intends to take on Gerard's identity by killing him to escape being hanged for murder. So the plot of the play, actually, it is a thrilling plot. It is a plot that has suspense. So it deals with the wishful thinking of a criminal who intends to take Gerard's identity by killing him. So with this plot, the play should have been a very serious one. But the author, Douglas James, rather than dealing with such a grievous storyline in a grave manner or in a serious manner, he chooses subtle humor that gives relief to the reader amidst hair-raising moments. So jaise play, we are reading the play, so ekdam se suspense create hota hai, ekdam se thrill create hota hai, but again, usi time, Gerard ka ek sarcastic or ek amusing remark aa jata hai, jo ki play ko again light kar deta hai. So it gives relief to the reader amidst hair-raising moments. So nowhere the humor is loud or overpowering. So jo humor hai ye, humor itna bhi zyada nahi hai ki is play ko ek funny play bana de. So it is not loud or overpowering. Gerard's sarcastic remarks, they are loaded with humor. So he mocks at the intruder when he says that it didn't require a great brain to break into my little cottage. So is tarah ke remarks jo hai wo reader ko hasate hain. So it is quite amusing for the reader when Gerard comments about the intruder's appearance that you are particularly not decorated. So humor in the story is also used to bring forth the cool temperament of Gerard. So now from this humor only we come to know that Gerard, he is not at all nervous. He is not at all afraid of intruder. He's rather keeping his cool. He's sitting calmly and maybe he's planning his next action. So it also acts as a tool to unnerve the intruder. So these remarks and these amusing remarks of Gerard also actually help to unnerve the intruder. Unnerve the intruder means jiso उसको अपने ऊपर बहुत कॉन्फिडेंस था कि मैं तो सबको डरा ही दूंगा, मैं तो जेरार्ड को एकदम से डरा के और फिर उसे मार के उसकी आइडेंटिटी ले लूँगा. सो लेकिन व्हेन ही फाइंड्स दैट जेरार्ड ही इज़ नॉट एट ऑल अफ्रेड, ही इज़ काम, ही इज़ क्वाइट, सो इवन इंट्रूडर ही set to think that what is happening here? Maybe I'm at the wrong place, maybe. Now the title, whether the title is justified or not. So the title of the play, if I were you, it is Justified. The intruder, in order to take on Gerard's identity to escape the police, hatches a plan to kill Gerard. So he hatches a plan. He's thinking, ki agar main aisa kar lun, agar main ja ke Gerard ko maar dun, to fir aisa ho jayega. So it is if, ki if I do this, if I do like this, then this would happen. So the whole plan is actually based on a supposition if. The play deals with the intruder's attempt to make his plan successful. So throughout the play, the intruder is actually trying to make his plan successful. But Gerard's presence of mind outwits the intruder and he's caught by the police. So thus, the intruder's desire to impersonate Gerard remains unfulfilled. So he is left high and dry with a speculation of if I were you. So uski ye soch, uska jo plan hai, if I were you, waise ka waise hi reh jata. And that is why the title of the play is apt and justified. So these are the image credits, and do watch grammar worksheet 1, 2 and 3 for your revision for the exams. That's all for today. The question bank, extracts, character sketch, they all I'll upload in the next video. So do subscribe and share this video with all your friends, and don't forget to hit the like button. So thank you for now and happy preparation.